In Britain today, more and more people are facing the struggle of coming out as homosexual. 1.5% of men are openly gay, and these numbers are slowly rising. The percentage of lesbians in Britain is less, however, they still face the same hard struggle. So let's look at some of the experiences that people had when faced with the issue of coming out.
The 21st century, after all, so what is the big issue with being gay? We've got celebrities, college students and high school students to give their opinion on it and to say it's okay to be who you are. So why is it so difficult coming out in this country?
I just think there's a lot of prejudice in this country still, and no one's like, it's still back in the 70s, so.
We went out onto the streets of St. Helens to find out people's opinions on the attitude towards homosexuality today.
Like, most, like, gang of lads, like, their things, like, just, like, they're scared of us, like, they think we're going to jump all over them, but we're not like that. Like, we're just normal people, they just talk to us.
I live more in high school because the people are not immature enough, they don't understand, and they have to stick their makeup up and everything. But in college, it's just normal, you can wear makeup and dress up, you can just be open about it.
Yeah, I definitely think that it's changed. People are more accepting of it now. They know that people can be who they want to be, but years ago, I think that the people were a little bit more old-fashioned, so they didn't really know much about it.
Kate Owen is a 20-year-old lesbian who came out to her family and friends. Here is her story on how she came out.
I was 13 when I first realised that I was gay. I kept that to myself for a few years because I was nervous about telling people, and I wasn't really sure myself whether that was the case or not, or whether I was just confused. When I turned 16, I told a couple of my friends who persuaded me to tell my family. I told my younger brother first. Luckily, he was fine with it, and he went on to tell me to come out to the rest of my family. So one weekend when I was driving to the lakes with my mum, I decided that it was a good idea to tell her. I then went on to tell my dad as well, and luckily my whole family were fine with it. When I was 17, my ex-partner proposed to me, and to me, I didn't hesitate to say yeah. Like, I just thought it was the same as if a guy proposed. We got married when I was 18, well, entered into a civil partnership. Unfortunately, like, her family didn't take it well at all. My mum didn't come to the ceremony, but luckily all my family were fine about it and they all showed up. But I struggled to come to terms with it when I was younger. Before I'd come out to any of my friends and family, I didn't really know who I was, and I was confused and stuff. That led to a few depression issues, some self-harming. Luckily, I came out the other side of that, and now that I know who I am and stuff, and everybody, since I came out, everybody's comfortable with it, and so am I. My advice to anybody that is coming out, to any like friends and family, is just to sort of accept it in themselves, and just be true to who you are, really, and just go for it.
I'm sure, as we all know, in early 2013 the gay marriage laws had changed, so we went out onto the streets of St. Helens to see what people's opinions of this were.
Like, in the Bible, say, like, religion people, it's in the Bible, like, man and woman, Adam and Eve and all of that.
Yeah.
But it's that they're scared of what it is.
I think basically for other people will think, oh, it's a bit wrong and that, but other people think it's all right because I'm like it, I'm who I am. Like, they can't really change who they are, really.
Again, I think that you can marry who you want to marry, you can love who you want to love, you can be who you want to be with, so I think that it's a good thing that people know they can be accepted for who they are.
I think the church and religion was one of the big problems with it, really, wasn't it? And then I think it stops the, like, discrimination against people. I think that's really good, actually.
We went to Granada Studios and we interviewed Charlie Condou, who plays Marcus on Coronation Street, to hear his story of how he came out.
I knew that all my male friends had girlfriends, and most of my female friends had boyfriends. I knew that I was the only single one. But I kind of just thought that was because I was a late developer and that it would happen. And I think I probably got teased a bit about not having a girlfriend, but it wasn't like, you haven't got a girlfriend because you're gay. I was just teased because, you know, I was single and everybody else was pairing up at school. When I got the part, they said, they were very clear that they wanted a very different type of gay man to Sean. Even though they wanted us to be in a relationship, they wanted to look at a different type of gay man. And Marcus is very definitely that. You know, and he's quite responsible and quite together and knows himself very well, or at least he has. I mean, certainly the recent storyline has thrown a bit of a spanner in the works. But yeah, and I suppose I'm quite similar to him. I'm probably not quite as sensible as he is. But yeah, in a lot of ways, we're quite similar. When they first told me about the storyline, I was concerned about it. I really was, because the one thing that we're sure of is that Marcus is very comfortable being a gay man. He knows absolutely who he is, and comfortable in his sexuality. Then when they talked to me about the storyline as a whole and where they're going to end up with it, which obviously I can't really talk about, but I was a lot more comfortable with it, and I was more interested. And essentially what they wanted to do was look at what happens when a gay man falls in love with a woman, which does happen. It may not be particularly usual, but it does happen, and they were really interested in looking at that. And one thing that we'll certainly see more of is that Marcus makes no apology for being gay, and he still identifies as gay. He doesn't believe that he's a straight man, even though he has a girlfriend at the moment, and he is genuinely in love with her. And I think that kind of stuff is going to come back at a later date to bite him on the ass. I was really lucky in that I was brought up in quite an open-minded liberal family. So when I finally sort of came to terms with it, it wasn't much of a problem for me to tell my parents or my sister. And they were generally quite accepting. In fact, funnily enough, their biggest fear was that I wouldn't be a parent, because they knew how much that was important to me. And of course now I've got two kids, so. I think it's always really important to try and be true to yourself as much as you can. Having said that, I'm well aware that it's really difficult coming out. I would say go easy on yourself. You don't need to make any big, bold decisions. Try and find somebody that you're close to and that you trust, that you can perhaps come out to first, and take it slowly. You don't have to do a big, this is me and this is who I am, and get used to it. You know, sometimes it doesn't work like that in families. You have to be a bit cautious, because it's not only is it a big change for yourself, but it's a big change for everybody else as well. So sometimes acceptance can be slow to come. So yeah, I'd say if people are thinking of coming out, absolutely they should do it, because there's nothing worse than living a lie. But go easy on yourself. Don't you know, take your time. Do it at your own pace.
Charlie Condou is a patron of the Albert Kennedy Trust. This trust helps to rehome people who live in hostile environments and have been rejected by the parents. Their website is www.akt.org.uk. You can visit this website if you need any help or advice on anything, and they will do their utmost to help you out. Ollie is an 18-year-old drama student who currently attends St. Helens College. He is undergoing gender reassignment, and he's here to tell us his story on how he came out to his family and his friends.
I am transgendered, and I came out last year, August last year. I've had one appointment so far with, I think it was a psychiatrist person, and he asked me a bunch of questions. Most of, well, my close family know now. And I have my next appointment August this year, so. I think I always knew, but I never really acknowledged it until I was about 14, 15. Miles first, I don't know, and over Facebook, and then I actually put it all on Facebook. I wrote a big paragraph thing, so it's easier that way, and then I got it out there, and everybody knew, well, people who saw it, and I just asked my dad, could I have an appointment at the doctor's, and he was like, what for? And I was like, I told him, yeah. And I just told my mum, she was fine. School was, at the beginning, it was like, I got bullied in school for it. They'd call me like man and stuff, because he wasn't allowed to wear trousers in my school. He had to wear a skirt, so they was like, what is that? Is that a boy or a girl? And I'd be like, So, but towards the end of school, like, I just learned to get used to it, got over it, and just like, shut up. It died down like towards year 9, year 10, 11, but it never really stopped, really. College is very, very different, because it's just so much better here. You can just be yourself, really. And tutors were great and everything. There was one incident. The big, the beginning of the second year, but that was it really. Well, my mum and dad, they don't live together. My mum's great with it, but my dad, like even now, he's struggling to come, like, call me the right things, you know, like he and she and stuff. It's just like, my nan and granddad, I'm close to them, they just, seems like they're completely ignoring it. But it's fine, they're fine with it. They don't say anything cruel about it. So it's good, apart from little, small things.
So as you can see, coming out in this country isn't as difficult as it seems. So if you are thinking about coming out, don't hesitate, because there'll always be someone there to guide you through it.
Yes, it's getting better, but we've still got a long way to go.